This is the Galaxy Watch Ultra, Samsung's newest addition to its Android-powered line of wearable devices. And like it or not, the first impressions of the device are very similar to the Apple Watch Ultra. Whether it's the international orange or the squarified body, or even the name itself, comparing the Galaxy Watch Ultra to the Apple Watch Ultra seems inescapable. And why not? It's not the first time Samsung used the popular trend to make a quick buck. Right, Sammy? But to say the Galaxy Watch Ultra is an exact copy of the Apple Watch Ultra would be unfair. For example, the Galaxy Watch Ultra has a slightly rounder shape, a digital crown that acts as a button but doesn't turn, and what looks like a rotating bezel that frustratingly doesn't budge a centimeter. And while Samsung says this watch should only be used in shallow water, at risk of voiding your warranty I might add, I think we need to take a peek beneath the surface and do a deep dive on this hardware. Let's start with those international orange bands. Flip the watch over and it's just like looking at the Apple Watch Ultra. Depress a small button and the bands are released. I'll say that the mechanism Samsung is using here feels a lot smoother and easier to use than Apple's version. Now, you might remember that the Apple Watch Ultra and Ultra 2 both had 4 torque screws on the sensor plate that led to nowhere and did nothing but nullify the water resistance. To get to the internals of both Ultras, we had to go through the expensive OLED screen. Not so with the Galaxy Watch Ultra. Those tri-point screws are the start of our disassembly journey. There's some adhesive and a gasket in place to help prevent water ingress, and like the Apple Watch Ultra, the sensor plate detaches by popping this press connector. With the sensor plate away, we can take a closer look at the strap attachment mechanism. This again is an entirely different mechanism to what we see on the Apple Watch line, and feels a little bit more durable to me. The main board of the device looks to be the next component to come out, and surprisingly, it's only secured by press connectors and a single screw. Underneath those heavy-duty shields, we can spot the ARM Cortex-based Exynos W1000 processor supported by 2GB of RAM and 32GB of storage. Unlike the odd choice of tri-point for the sensor plate, the interior screws are all Phillips heads, and that's very welcome when comparing it to the fiddly process of removing tiny tri-point screws in the Apple Watch Ultra. The rather stocky battery is glued in pretty tight, but it's sitting on a tray which makes removal a little bit easier. Here we can again see a design choice that is in stark contrast to Apple's approach of fully encasing their battery. Rated for 2.25 watt-hours, the battery is very close but slightly larger than the Apple Watch Ultra's 2.09 watt-hours. With the mainboard and battery out of the way, I now have access to the bracket holding the speaker assembly in place. I'm surprised that there isn't any glue here. The whole assembly is pressure fitted, which makes the gasket around the assembly a critical service component if you plan to dive with this watch. Prying away at some cables reveals the haptic motor, which takes up a fair amount of space inside the housing, and it's glued down pretty well too. Another bracket reveals access to the 3 side buttons, but other than that, the housing only has one major component left, the screen. Before I can remove the screen, I need to extract this cosmetic bezel. The mechanical bezel of previous Galaxy watches are gone. This one performs no function other than to protect the screen itself from impact. With the bezel out, I can apply heat directly to the OLED panel and lift it away. It comes up easily enough, but having an additional part like that bezel to remove during screen replacement is annoying, especially when that part has no real function. Now that we've seen the hardware, I think it's fair to say that any similarities between the Galaxy Watch Ultra and the Apple Watch Ultra are skin deep. As far as repairability is concerned, the Galaxy Watch Ultra is slightly more accessible than the competition, mainly owing to its rear entry design. That being said, it still remains to be seen if Samsung will support these watches with manuals, parts, and reasonable access to the critical gaskets and adhesives that keep this device water resistant. With that in mind, we're giving the Galaxy Watch Ultra a provisional repairability score of 7 out of 10.